one is a focus on oligosaccharide.
Do you need 2 minutes? Is there any questions in the meantime? It's a fascinating topic, isn't it? I mean, it just opens up so many more questions.
Breastfeeding is an actor, but we could act on the actor, and it's. So human milk oligosaccharide, it's a long story, start a long time ago. It's an exchange between pediatrician, microbiologist and chemist. In the 19th century, they made the constat that 30% of mortality in breastfeeding children. It was in the 19th century, but actually we know that there is a high diversity and specific concentration of oligosaccharide in human milk, and with new technology like spectrometry mass spectrometry, they could be also biomarker for nutrition milk. So HMO have a wide spectrum of benefit for breastfeeding infant, and that belong to prebiotic aspect, but we could show in this slide that it's more than prebiotic aspect. So memory, prebiotic is a substrate that is selectively utilized by host microorganisms conferring a health benefit. It's the definition. And a probiotic, living microorganisms, bacteria or yeast, that are added as supplements to certain food and non-food products. And we could see that human milk oligosaccharide are implicated in these two definitions. Donc, who are them? After the lactose and fat, it is the first most important component of the milk of a woman. You can see here. The structure of human milk oligosaccharide is original simple. It's 5 monosaccharides, glucose, galactose, and acid. But after, it becomes more and more complex with specific structure of human milk oligosaccharide that are determinant for their function. And there is a branch outstructure trisaccharide. It's a wide variety. There is more than 200 of them in human milk. It's the unique, like microRNA, human milk is the unique fluid with the most, the high number of oligosaccharide. But not all women secrete the same human milk oligosaccharide. It's what is important. It participates, for instance, in the prevention of enterocolitis like that one, but we see later. Biosynthesis in the epithelial cell of the mammary gland is really complex, but we could see here the process. And what is important is that this process evolves during the age of lactation and could be influenced by environments. It's why it's really close to epigenetic slides. Here you can see that there is a high contain of human milk oligosaccharide in colostrum, less in mature milk, and there is a limited fucosylation in immature breast gland. So it's why it's probably important to say to the mother, if a woman gives her milk and she has a term baby, is milk have less protein but have more human milk oligosaccharide, fucosylation mucosaccharide. So it's a new balance, and we could use that to say that your milk is important for us also. So human milk depends on stage and term of lactation. You can see here on the slide. depends also of geographical origin and maternal diet, you can see here. But one thing important is that the expression of glycosyl transferase in the mammary gland depends on the group H and Lewis. So there is genetic factor, epigenetic, and micronutrient factor that modify expression of HMO. You can see here on the map that 90% of the population are secretor plus. So they have high level of human milk in their milk. It's better for us. But 20% of them probably have less oligosaccharide. Oligosaccharide and blood type have a really same profile. There is four profiles of milk depend of Jen Lewis and secretor group also. And mother's milk with who are secretory positive contain more oligosaccharide and more fructosaccharide than the other mothers. Okay. This probably explains also why in total population study we have not always the same result for breastfeeding baby also, like epigenetic and influence of neurologic development and the gene expression. So actually there is new method of analysis, high performance liquid chromatography, capillary electrophoresis, and now we know a lot, most of the human oligosaccharide. You can see here the difference with the little name and the long name. What are the characteristics of the human milk oligosaccharide? They withstand extreme conditions. They are not destroyed by gastric acidity, pancreatic and digestive enzyme. And it's why we found them in the stool. They are not digested at all level and found intact in the colic level. And probably why they have an action on the microbiote. They resist to freezing. They resist to pasteurization, freeze drying. And it's important for us in human milk bank because our milk still have oligosaccharides. So we deliver a milk with all oligosaccharide inside. It's really important to explain the benefits of human milk to prevent enterocolitis, infectious disease. Because sometimes people say, your milk is pasteurized, he have no power. He have power. A lot of studies have been made with pasteurized milk, and we have to still to say it. It is excreted in stool, but what is important is that it's, we found oligosaccharide in urine, in blood, and this explains the local and the systemic effect of oligosaccharide. And there is a modification. You can see that if there are high level of oligosaccharide on between 2 days and 2 months, we start to see HMO degradation products in 3 months and 6 months, and after diversification there is no oligosaccharide. So it's like epigenetic modification. Oligosaccharide in milk when the baby need oligosaccharide. There is few factors that influencing the composition and colonization of newborn intestinal microbiota, and oligosaccharide participate at the microbiota intestinal. Bifidobacteria are the main user of human milk oligosaccharide in the intestinal tract and dominate the microbia of breastfed child. It's an essential role in the establishment of the dominated colic bacteria ecosystem in the child by Bifidobacteria, in particular Bifidobacterium bifidum. And children breast by mothers no secretories have a delay in establishment of bifidobacterium line in their microbia. So it's why also in few studies, babies who have been breastfeeding have gastroenterocolitis, you couldn't explain and prevent everything because there is variation from mother to mother. So HMO have a pluripotent effect. They are metabolic for commensal bacteria, so they are prebiotic. They prevent adhesion to pathogens. They modulate gene expression at the epithelial cell and expression of sulfate glucan and its similarity between epigenetic effect of human milk. They stimulate cytokine production by lymphocytes. They reduce mucosal infiltration by white blood cells and their action. They influence differentiation and proliferation. Their effects affixing the epithelium and provide sialic acid essential to breast development. So we can explain also better brain development by human milk with HMO. So few slides about the different effect of HMO. Okay. So HMO and infection, bacterial and viral. I don't know why. Few of my slides are in French. There is an antibacterial role against diarrhea, against respiratory infection with streptococcus, against pneumoniae, against also urinary tract infection. So it participates to prevention also to other pathology than gastrointestinal pathology, and a prevention of colonization and streptobe infection, which is the more frequency infections in neonatal period. It participates also to antifungal infection and have an antiviral role, which is really, really, really important in the mechanism of action to prevent, to reduce HIV infection. So we must promote also breastfeeding in Africa, in different countries with high level of, because also of that, to prevent use of water with bacteria inside, but also to promote breastfeed who give own prevention to HIV disease. And what is important is that the mechanism of action of HMO prevent resistor linked to mutation of virus, unlike vaccine and antiviral treatments. So it's better prevention because it could be continued. HMO reduce bacterial and viral adhesion and stimulate immune response. Second action, allergies and HMO. Allergy, it's 1 million individuals in the world. Food allergy, the second wave of epidemic, 5% of adults, 8% of child. And anti-allergic role of HMO is essential. It's an indirect and a specific direct role. It's influencing microbiota, it's indirect role. And specific direct, it's reduced release of secondary chemokine. It stabilizes mast cells, induce IL-10, reduce gene expression inflammation, compete with other glycoprotein to other intracellular adhesion molecular, and stimulate balanced TH1, TH2, and reduce also platelet release. So a specific multiple action. And in fact, in that study, we could explain prevention of asthma with breastfeeding by HMO. Incidence of pediatric asthma has increased recently decade. And some people say that it's loss of old thread microbe from human microbia, resulting in a less diverse and dysbiotic gut microbia that influence asthma. So it's the relation between a microbiote and asthma development. Early life exposed to influenced microbiota play a crucial role in the benefic role of breastfeeding. There are conflicting reasons due to the variation of milk composition between individual and cross-population, is what I said last slide. And human milk have prebiotic and probiotic properties that modulates to the main force control the gut community assembly and body size over the gut, wave, air waves, nasopharyngeal cavity. So it's a synergic and additive effect against pediatrician asthma between HMO and milk microbiota. HMO also participate at cause milk protein prevention. Mothers of children with milk allergy have lower level of one of the HMO in their milk, and the content of LST and the 2SL are lower in mother's milk with atopic dermatitis. Donc, not only on Comil's allergia, but also on atopic dermatitis and other disease of the skin. And for us, pediatricians in intensive care, it's really important in, for enterocolitis. Enterocolitis actually is a more common complication and sometimes fatal in premature. Its incidence still high, 5 to 10% of the under 1.5 kilo. A quarter died or survivor have great risk of neurologic sequelae and short life. And study in rats show that HMO protect against enterocolitis, especially that one. Women's milk, we know, reduced 10 to 5 times enterocolitis. And in fact, DSL intake will be a predictive biomarker and a new therapeutic. And a human milk bank participate to the reduction of enterocolitis, probably. In fact, with their HMO, in the fact that HMO are not destroyed by freezing and by pasteurization, and because fluconazylation is more active in term babies, so in the milk from the donator. So the role of HMO in prevent enterocolitis is quite complicated. Action on immaturity dejection, turnover epithelial, increased permeability and defect of production mucus. And this influence the pro-inflammatory cytokine, and HMO control pro-inflammatory gene expression, so epigenetic action, mature intestinal function, activate intestinal motor, regulate enterocolitis proliferation, reduce SFSC production and activate an infiltration polynuclear. Last slide about HMO and neurological development. This is the Brazil study who found the benefit for all the population, but we know that it's more more important for preterm breastfeed baby. We found that the chicken supplement with casein SIA enhance the ability of learning memorize, and concentration of acid sialic, the special HMO, brain increase in the last month of pregnancy and in those 2 years. HMO is a source of acid sialic, and postmortem concentration of brain is increased in newborn breastfeed comparison with newborn with no breastfeeding. HMO participate to brain growth, expression of certain development growth gene and its epigenetic modification, and SIA gangliosid and polyglycoprotein involve in neurological development. This is really the same slide that the slide of epigenetic and obesity. So I just speak of that. Just to say that composition of breast milk is modified with growth and body composition relate. You can see at 1 month, at 6 months, HMO human milk and decrease fat and weight with increase of HMO concentration in milk. Last benefit is for the woman. We have speak about prevention concept with epigenetic and human milk. Human milk prevent, human milk is present in maternal circulation during pregnancy. This study is quite interesting because we can see non-pregnant human, pregnant human, and human milk. There is HMO in maternal circulation during pregnancy. So it could explain few prevention for the mother, the prevention of mastitis. Sometimes we didn't find why the mother have mastitis. She doesn't have stopped breastfeeding. She had, and it's family risk, for instance. 2FL and other HMO interact with Staphylococcus, and Staphylococcus is very frequent in mastitis. And also urinary infection prevention, HMO in urine women is higher when women have less infection, urinary infection. So there is a release into circulation of human milk, oligosaccharide, and there is probably systemic effect in the mother, and this starts during pregnancy. So last slide, to resume, and it's quite difficult in white slide, the implication of human milk saccharide on health. There is a systematic and anti-infective effect, and this participates to prevention allergy and inflammatory pathology. There is a prevention of pathogen adhesive and intestinal intestinal epithelium, and this probably participates to viral and bacterial infection. And that they influence the process of maturation of the intestine and the brain, and this participates to enterocolitis prevention and development cognitive. So for the perspective, probably new therapeutic perspective, since the discovery of HMO more than 60 years ago, there is several challenges: development of identification method and characterization, availability of pure fraction of HMO in large quantity for functional studies. Progress have been made over the past 10 years, structural analysis of the small volume of milk bank of human milk. HMO, one of the major difference between cow and human milk, you can see here. And the production of large quantity of purified human milk, but only one human milk had been added on formula. So we are far, far, far than the human breast milk. And to conclude, breastfeeding remains the most appropriate way to provide the greatest diversity of and maximum of HMO, and in the most ecological and economical way to protect maternal child health and the planet. Thanks very much.
Thank you for your talk. Any questions? Is there any questions for Dr. Virgin?
Okay. I have a question.
Okay.
Thank you for this nice presentation. This is Elvesta. I was just wondering that the HMO, those pregnant women that are with drug problems, so does it affect their HMO, I think, right? Hello?
Yes, sorry, I didn't understand the question. Could you repeat,
those,
please?
Those drug patient with the drug problem, pregnant. So I think the quality of HMO, I think, will be affected, no? For those patient with the drug problem?
No, quality of Hashimoto is not so much affected by drug use. It could be affected by other situation, age of lactation, prematurity, environment, and blood group. Some medication could modify HMO and so could modify the microbiote of the milk and microbiote of the mother and microbiote of the baby, way of the deliver and other things. But specifically, use of drug is not a specific act of modification and impact. It could be better. In fact, it's better to be breastfeeding with or without drugs, and it still have a recommendation.
Oh, okay, because I was thinking for those, drug addicts or something like that who got pregnant, and so that's what I was thinking. Maybe it would affect the HMO, but. So not necessarily the patient that are taking medication, is those drug abuse people, the one addict people.
It's not so essential on all the oligosaccharide, all the HMO, perhaps few of them. And you can see that some of the HMO are specific, have a specific effect on cerebral development over on microbial efficiency. And probably it could be interesting, in fact, to have some study about a few HMO who are specifically implicate in neurologic development, probably.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, thank you, Dr. Virgin and Dr. Alvesa, for your question. Can we start next lecture?